Hello, world. It's Mr. Resistor here again, continuing our Alpha Newbro experience. Alright, let's see. Looks like the daily today is Battlecruiser Proving Grounds. So, guess we won't be participating in that one. But that's fine. Let's see what's on offer here. Right, so repair, mining, like combat and more mining. Well, you know what? Oh, is this? Wait, destroy the rogue drones and mine for the Veldspar for your agent. Right, okay. Going to, we'll delay that one. Okay. We'll do this other mining one. And we'll save this one for tomorrow also. Okay.
Warp drive active.
A frigate skin, cool. Alright, we'll go ahead and redeem that. And let's see. Drone avionics and repair systems. That's cool. Where are we at on our skill plans? Working on surgical strike. That's a little too far out. Okay. Cool. So we'll go ahead and orbit this guy. Start our mining lasers. And launch our drones. What? What am I missing? Light drone operation one. Okay. How did I miss that? Well, looks like we're gonna have to buy one. Fortunate. Okay. Train that right away. So let's check out our other skill plans here. Like Alpha Minor might be. Processing, negotiation. We'll get those eventually. Shield operation. Let's go ahead and track this one. All right. Well, this is annoying. I've got a pirate after us and nothing to kill him with. For another 17 minutes. Go ahead and hit our afterburners. That should reduce his ability to do damage to us. Hopefully we can hold out until we're done training the skill we need to fly these drones. In the meantime, Project Discovery. That's got to be two.
completed.
All right. Now we should be able to launch our drones. There we go. All right, let's target this guy and take him out. Grab that loot. Set our salvage laser and turn off the afterburner so that we're not looping too far away. Cytometry, cool.
The asteroid is depleted.
All right. That one's done. So we retrieve our drones and head back to turn this in.
Warp drive active.
That's not what I wanted to do. Wrong button.
Warp drive.
Come back here
active.
In a minute.
Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted.
Process this. Oh yeah, that's a scanning quest. All right, well, we'll do that one next time. Tonight we're just mining.
Warp drive active.
All right, so warp in. We launch drones. Because if we get attacked while we have them out, by default they will attack back. But these guys are not being aggressive, so we'll go ahead and engage them ourselves. So now you might have noticed that I have my mining lasers both pointed at different rocks up here. You can see if I hover over this or on this end, it'll show this slight little line to show me which one is which. So it goes from here to the actual rock and to the module. So, you know, if you're in a situation where you have a bunch of mining lasers, that can be really handy. Anyway, the point of targeting separate rocks is basically for efficiency. When one of these rocks runs out, then only one laser will be deactivated, the other one will still be going, then I can get it going on the third rock. Since there are only three rocks in this case, you know, both of them will end up being on that last rock. But if you've got both of your mining lasers targeted at one rock, it'll mine that one rock faster. But then, you know, you lose a little bit of time retargeting them when that rock is depleted. So, and when I'm drone mining, I'll do a similar thing, right? I'll have each drone on a separate rock, so I only have to retarget one of them at a time. Now, another thing you can do is you're not stuck with things being arranged the way that these are. For this top row, I believe it the way it is. I usually put things that can't be activated on the bottom row. And I'll have my top row for weapons, salvaging, other sort of active or offensive systems. And then the second row is usually my defensive or propulsion modifications, so, or modules, I should say. Some people will remove all non-activatable items from this, and they'll have it separated out so that they can overload. Have them grouped in terms of which ones they would want to overload together. I don't generally use overload. I believe you need to have thermodynamics in order to do that, and I don't know if that is an alpha skill. I think it is not. Is it in here? Which one is it under? Engineering, maybe? Thermodynamics. Oh, it is available to alphas. How much does that cost? Almost 6 million. Wow. When we get to the point where that's relevant, we'll think about spending the money. Let's see. Yeah, so basically once you've got that, you overheat the modules, which makes them do more of whatever, so you get more speed, more damage, etc. But it damages the modules in the process. So when you do get back to a station, you'll have to pay to repair them. Which is why I generally don't do it. But it's certainly useful in some situations. And when we get into some of the more difficult content later on, it might make sense to start doing that. All right. Well, looks like I'm full, so we'll go ahead and turn that off. Bring back our drones. And we will head back home.
Warp drive active. Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted.
Complete the mission, and let's see what he's got up next. That's gonna be a delivery. All right, so we will do that later. Oh yeah, let's see what we got for our rewards. Rifter Crucial skin, cool. And Talos Biosecurity. Nice. Let's see what else we got. And some ISK. Right on. So we'll go ahead and claim that. And my dog was whining at me, so I gotta go give her some attention. So that's gonna be it for tonight. Oh, wait. We got a skill. Almost missed that. Reprocessing. Okay, let's get that training. That is going to increase the amount of stuff we get when we reprocess ores and ice. And we'll do drones first. You will notice there's a separate skill for scrap metal processing, and that's why I'm saving my scrap metal, because I can't reprocess it efficiently, so it's probably going to be more profitable to just sell it to someone who does have this skill. Alright, so with that, call it a day. Have a good one, everyone. Until next time.